I'll be like, sheesh, sunset on the beach.
This week on Cougar Media News, we're going to take a look into what our lunch ladies do for our school, see a teacher and a student swap places, and then hear some mic'd up from our baseball team. Cougar Media News starts now.
Bring the heat. Freeze frame!
This is Simmone Bucher
and Jake Deimling here with another episode of Cougar Media News.
Have you ever thought about the preparation that goes into the school meals each day? Lizzie, Ashley, and I got the chance to see what goes on behind the scenes at the cafeteria.
Here at Palmyra High School, there's a very devoted cafeteria staff. Taking a look into the daily life of a lunch lady shows what they go through to prepare the meals for students.
When we come in the morning, we start breakfast right away. We have to get things out of the freezer. We can't let them out overnight. They have to be kept refrigerated. And then we prepare your breakfast, and while somebody's serving your breakfast, someone else is getting your lunch started.
Becoming a lunch lady can sometimes be a difficult thing for someone to take on. Dealing with students all throughout the day is a challenge the lunch ladies have to face.
Well, the high school kids are very polite, and they're willing to tell us if we try something new. They're willing to taste it and let us know. So we don't require anything from the children. We don't require testing. We don't require them to be quiet. We just give them food and they like to eat.
Students should definitely appreciate the lunch ladies and all they do for us. The work that they put in for the students is very selfless.
I chose to be a lunch lady. Number one, I like to cook, but the schedule was perfect for when my children were in school.
The lunch ladies are heroes here at Palmyra. Next time you get your lunch, make sure to greet them with a smile.
This is Ashley Yorty,
Simone Bucher,
and Lizzie Zampedri reporting for Cougar Media News.
Thanks, guys. Make sure to say thank you next time you get a school meal for all the hard work the staff puts in every day. Congratulations to Scott Shipley for being named March's Rotary Student of the Month.
Fall cheerleading tryouts are open to all students in the Palmyra Area School District who will be entering grades 7 through 12. For the 2022-2023 school year. Practices are on Monday, March 21st and 22nd from 6 to 8 at Langle. Wednesday, March 23rd, practice will be held at the middle school. Tryouts are Thursday, March 24th at 5:30 at Langle. Good luck to all girls trying out.
As the conflict continues to increase in Ukraine, staff members at Della Vita and Manny Rose got the opportunity to share more about what is going on.
With tensions between Russia and Ukraine continuing to rise, at Manny B. Rose and I, at underscore Ovita underscore, are here to keep you in the loop with what's going on. On March 7th, French women gathered together in Paris to protest the Russian invasion. This is one of the many protests that are happening in these surrounding countries. Ukraine's military accuses a Russian aircraft of firing near Belarus borders, endangering border villages. Russian forces also bombed a children's hospital in southern Ukraine, killing 3 people.
On March 14th, Russia reportedly asked for military equipment from China. This was the 38th time Russian President Putin and Chinese President Xi Jinping have met. Alongside military equipment, Putin asked for economic support to counteract the sanctions put in place by the United States and the European nations. Russia and Ukraine continue to talk to hopefully bring an end to the war. To stay updated with these events, be sure to join us back next week for more information.
Back to Jake and Simone at the desk.
Thank you guys for sharing this important information. Cougar Media News will continue to update on this crisis. Congratulations to our cast and crew of the SpongeBob musical on yet another great show and trip to Bikini Bottom.
Speaking of trips, there is still time to sign up to travel to Italy and Spain this summer. The deadline to sign up for the trip is March 23rd. Interested students can reach out to Mr. Machia or Mrs. Dottori with any questions.
Staff members Jake and Jordan had the opportunity to mic up a few players and show what goes on at a typical baseball practice.
As baseball season gets started, we had the opportunity to mic up a few players, first being Tim Hall.
He's faster than you.
But he runs like an angry.
But he's still faster than you.
He's not faster than me.
That is true.
He doesn't run like an angry toddler.
I think I'd rather run like an angry toddler and be
that fast.
X, you're giving me a buzz cut, bro. Final decision.
There's snow on the turf yesterday.
Yeah, there was literally snow on this field yesterday, and I'm out here practicing in like 80 degree weather. It's like being down in Florida. Dude, an 8-hour bus ride, I don't even know if I'm ready for that. I ain't doing no homework, I can tell you that right now. I don't even know if I'm gonna bring my school laptop. Bring the heat.
And the throw.
Now we have Jake Deimling to give us his perspective.
Yeah. Wheels or doors?
It's gotta be wheels.
You're a wheels man?
It's gotta be.
Hey, ball's in, let's go! Let's go!
No, it's doors.
I thought you were wheels.
No, I'm a team door guy.
Or chase guy.
Robbie, you look scared. What's wrong with you? All right?
He's gonna cry, coach.
Robbie's fearless.
I hope the team is doing well down in Myrtle Beach. Just a reminder that free tutoring is available every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday in the high school library. Have you ever noticed the movie casting signs hanging up around the building? Logan and Zach had the chance to talk to the cast of Bodyguard to find out what it is about.
Mike McCarthy is a student here at Palmyra Area High School. He's making a student film called The Bodyguard, and we got a chance to interview him on how he will do it and what his plans are for the future.
The people in the movie right now are me as a small part, Alec Airgood, Mason Whitney, and Derek Witherson. But, you know, there's a lot of moving parts and we're still looking for a few more roles. The movie is about a dude who has a hit put on him by the mafia, so he has to hire a bodyguard, but he ends up hiring a husband-wife bodyguard duo, so it ends up an action comedy. We're aiming for a June 7th release date right now, you know, right around the end of the school year, and we're working hard towards that. We are going to film this movie at various locations around Palmyra, houses, a restaurant, so various places. And we're going to try to air it in some sort of theater. Hopefully, I'm thinking maybe the Allen Theater or Flagship, but there's a lot of work to be done, but we are working towards that. It's always been a passion of mine to create a movie or some other thing like it to show off my creative skills and my writing skills, and I feel like this is the right time to do it, and I'm excited for this opportunity.
This is Zach Garl
and Logan Osborne reporting for Cougar Media News.
Stay tuned for this movie and what it has to unfold this June. The freshman class is holding a Mr. Sticky's fundraiser with all orders due on the 22nd. Mrs. Selfsmith in room 107 will take all order forms and money. Pickup will be here on the 30th at 3 p.m.
Being a student can be difficult sometimes. Cassie and Mallory had the chance to put teachers into some students' shoes to see what it is like.
We're going to be reading from page 178. What's happening?
Did you hear about Dog the Bounty Hunter?
No.
Well, I
did. Can you get out your book, Miss Eaton?
Yeah, yeah.
Miss Eaton, can you get out your book, please?
Yeah, I will.
Am I going to have to take your phone, Miss Eaton?
No, I'm okay.
Okay. I'm going to start now, Miss Eaton.
Go Raiders!
Today we're going to be learning about radius stuff. Any questions? Yes, Zoe?
I don't get this already.
Okay, we're going to begin. Centric circles.
Does anybody get this?
Zoe, what's your question?
I don't even just know where to begin. I don't have a question because can't even get to a question.
Now we're going to hand you out your packet. This is due tomorrow. 50 questions.
Of course, it's due tomorrow. Everything's due tomorrow.
Use your textbook.
I left mine at home.
You can use mine.
Does anyone know how to find potential energy? Mike J!
According to your notes, on November 15th, it was a Wednesday, I believe we multiplied mass, gravity, and height. Isaac's also not paying attention.
Isaac. Miss Freeze.
What up?
I got my finger stuck in my hair. Can you help me?
Just...
Miss Frank! Miss Frank! Miss Frank! Help me, Miss Frank! Hi. Thanks, Peach.
Yep.
Got a new belt buckle.
Yeah.
You see it?
It's nice.
Gucci sew yesterday, Coco Chanel in now. Can I go to the bathroom?
5 minutes, max.
Mr. Thomason makes a great student. Last week, we went to see if teachers were able to guess students from their baby pictures. This week, Bobby and Quinn were able to test students to see if they could guess their teachers based on their baby pictures.
McCarthy.
The custodian. Miss April, right?
Oh, Robinson. Wait, was it Yusko? Keenan?
Yeah.
Thomason?
Yeah.
Bomb?
Yeah.
No.
Is it Mr. Gervinski?
Yeah.
Really?
How well do you know your siblings? Jordan and Mallory tested the Manning siblings to see how well they knew each other.
I'm Madeline Manning and I am 17.
I'm Andrew Manning and I'm 16 and we're siblings.
Yeah, I had to switch up my
name. Maddie. Yeah, it's fat.
See, this is just like a constant battle.
What do you mean? Go look at your room. That'd be cool. Or I'll say Maddie. I'm funny, hold up my name. That's a joke itself. Maddie is definitely the better one. She just gets away
time,
with stuff.
I'll give him a good lie, I guess. One time I was playing Minecraft at night and I told my mom I was on a call with my grandma.
You do that all the time. How do you get, well, you get favorited by mom. I get favorited by dad.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
That's all we have for you this week, PHS. Have a great weekend. We will be back again next week with another episode.